María Mercedes pa' servirle a usted. De mi familia me encargo yo. Mi madre no usa bandunú, porque mi padre jamás cumplió. María Mercedes pa' servirle a usted. Un buen día mi son cambió. Compró un cachito y me conoció. Y al morir un montón me heredó. María Mercedes pa' servirle a usted. Qué rico son el...
María Mercedes earns a living peddling the streets. Her father's an alcoholic, which is why her mother abandoned Maria Mercedes, her two brothers, and a sister. Then, one day, while selling lottery tickets on the street, she met Santiago del Olmo, a very wealthy man who's been struck with a terminal disease. He lives with his aunt Malvina and cousins Jorge Luis and Digna. Malvina is hoping Santiago will die soon, so she can get her hands on his fortune. However, Santiago gets Maria Mercedes to marry him and have her the sole beneficiary of his net worth, and call it sweet revenge against Malvina and his cousins. Santiago's death has Malvina high on heels. As the will is being read, however, it becomes obvious that Maria Mercedes is to keep everything. Malvina begins to lose her mind. Upon returning after living abroad, Magnolia, Maria Mercedes' mother, seeks her children and learns that Maria Mercedes is her daughter. For that matter, she takes on a different identity to help her. Malvina persuades her son to marry Maria Mercedes in an effort to get their hands on the fortune again. Jorge Luis doesn't really like Maria Mercedes' looks. With a pan of worms in the making, Malvina asks Maria that she accompany Jorge Luis to a social engagement. All, of course, to make Maria Mercedes look bad. However, as Maria Mercedes gets superbly dressed for the occasion, Jorge Luis is taken back by her astounding beauty. Well, as it turns out, Jorge Luis leaves Maria Mercedes pregnant. She's truly happy because she thinks Jorge Luis really loves her. Malvina, however, argues that the child does not belong to Jorge Luis. And such stories, of course, set a major distance between them both. When Malvina finds out Maria Mercedes has given birth, she hangs on the edge of schizophrenia because Santiago's fortune, of course, will end up in some other account, not hers. Magnolia finally tells Maria Mercedes that she's her mother. Meanwhile, Malvina hits the roof, breaks down, and is shut into an insane asylum all in one fell swoop. Misunderstandings aside, Jorge Luis asks Maria Mercedes to forgive him. She does, and they marry by the church. A story unique to this day and age. In a world of uncanny situations and difficult circumstances, a story so true, it's to be believed.